If you're getting the Valorant WAN1067 connection error, then we know how to fix it. Simply watch this video and learn how to solve it. Hey, you're watching Silicophilic, the home for all tech users. Valorant WAN1067 connection error is pretty common and can be easily fixed with a few tweaks. Here we have shown the way you can solve this problem. So watch this video till the end and perform all the provided solutions. Before we get into the solutions, subscribe to our channel for future tech support. Also like this video if it helps you solve this issue. If the issue isn't resolved from the solutions we have shown here, comment below to let us know and our team will try their best to help you out. We also have a Facebook group of troubleshooting experts where you can share your tech issues and get direct help. The link to the group is in the pinned comment. So, let's begin. The first thing you need to do is make sure the VGC service is enabled and the startup type is set to automatic. Press the Windows plus R keys to open Run. Type services.msc and press Enter to open the Services app. Look for the VGC service and double-click on it. Change the startup to automatic and click on Apply and OK to save the changes. Now, open Run again and type msconfig and press Enter. Select the Services tab and look for the VGC service. Make sure that the box next to it is checked. Click on Apply and OK to save the changes. Restart your PC and once it restarts, check if Valorant is able to connect now. Method 2. The next thing you can try is running flushing the DNS and resetting winsock. Type command prompt in the search bar and run it as administrator. Type ipconfig /flushdns in the command window and press enter. After the command finishes running, type netsh winsock reset in the command prompt and press enter. We have provided the command lines in the description of this video, so you can simply copy it from there. Method 3. The next thing you can do is reinstall the graphics drivers on your PC. This has worked for many users and should also work for you. Right-click on Start and select Device Manager. Expand Display Adapters and right-click on the graphics driver. Select Uninstall Device and follow as shown. After the driver is uninstalled, you will have to install it. For AMD graphics driver, you will need to install the Radeon app and run it. Similarly, for NVIDIA graphics drivers, you will need to install the GeForce Experience. Running these apps will automatically detect that the graphics drivers are missing and they will download and install them automatically. Restart your PC once the drivers are installed and run the app again to check for any updates. If any update is available, download and install them. So that's it. If this video has helped you in figuring this issue, then give us a like and subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to comment your feedback on the solutions or if you are facing any issue while performing them. Also join our Facebook group for direct tech support. The link to the group is in the pinned comment. Thanks for watching Silicophilic.